Oh my gosh. They told me a few months ago, they said, you know, we're going to do an episode where you box, because you box, right? And I'm like, yeah, I box. This is going to be awesome. I'm going to show off my skills. And like, and then I get the script and I was like, wait a second. You guys didn't tell me that I get knocked out. Right. I didn't agree to that.
And the Shiner, right?
Exactly. But you know, I think that it's good for people to see Kat feeling a little off, you know. I think she's so on top of her game that for her to be behind the eight ball for once in her life might be refreshing for the viewers.
Humbling. Yes.
Yes.
I guess this is the first episode that Kat's the lead here.
Yes.
Did you feel more responsibility as an actor, or was it just...
You certainly feel more responsibility, but I don't know that your process necessarily changes. You kind of apply the same thing, whether it's a small amount of material or a large amount of material. For me, it was about just keeping focused, keeping track of where I was in the script, what we already know, what we don't know. And while those are things that you normally focus on, you know, for me, there was obviously just a lot more material to sift through. And just generally, you're working a 65-hour week.
Right.
You know, and it also increased my respect for all the other actors on the show that have been doing that for years. So it was a balance, sort of a mental and physical balance to make sure that I was in good shape, slept well, ate right, yeah, all of that to make sure that every single day I could perform at my peak.
Have you ever done an episode of television where you were carrying the whole episode like that, where you were the lead?
I've had some pretty large guest stars in the past. I don't think that it was anything of this magnitude before.
So you were able to kind of experience what Kelly and Peter and Mariska and everybody's been doing for decades.
Yes.
And is there any points where you feel pressure, or you don't really think that way?
There's certainly pressure. You can't be the new girl and put out the worst episode of the season. You know? I mean, I also am, you know, I talk a big game. I have a lot of pride. I'm excited to have some way of displaying my boxing training, you know. So it was one of those things that even in just my own brain, I had to get it right for myself. And then I wanted to get it right for everyone else that I work with and works with me. You know, it's just kind of an important thing to bring your A game and be prepared. And if everybody meets at that level, I think that's how this show has gone on for 21 years.
Yeah, and I think there's a sense of the people who are watching, this is the first time they're seeing you really in that position. So, and I think it's great. There's kind of like been a lot of instances leading up to this where you've made mistakes or more rookie type errors. Was it feeling good to kind of be like doing it right?
You know, she gets it right, but there are still a few stumbles.
Yeah.
You know, there are still a few stumbles. She's never without a lesson, really, I think. And that's going to be the case for her first couple of years as it is in the squad room, I think. You know, she's going to have to learn from her mentors as much as I learn from being on set. You know, I say every day that I learn more and more of what I don't know.
Right.
And my seeming lack of knowledge in areas seems to grow the more I work, because I find out that there's more and more that I need to learn about. And I think that's the same for Kat. As she gets deeper in this case, I mean, her instincts were right.
Right.
And she followed those instincts and she was smart. And, you know, in the end, she got it right. But her tactics along the way still need a little bit of polishing. And you'll see that again in this episode.
They do. But I think the main thing was she walked into a room and she felt like something was wrong. And she acted on it. And that's really, in a sense, what your job is to do.
Right? Correct.
And had you not had that instinct, which you kind of can't teach, none of this would happen in this incredible journey that you go on for Esperanza. And these things that happen because of it, obviously, justice and her coming out about the assault, and she does have to go to jail for what happened. But you bring the sisters back together. And there's been a lot of episodes where maybe things don't wrap up. So that was nice to see.
Always.
Yeah. I think that you going a little extra made those things happen. And did you see that in the script that you had to maybe make that payment, or like you had to do extra things to move this forward?
This in particular was a much more personal case for her. She knew the people involved, and that's, in the past, she has been able to identify with the people involved. But in this case, she actually knew them and had a past relationship with them. So I think for her, part of her missteps throughout the episode come from this being a heart-led investigation for her, you know, not being able to separate her job from her personal life. You know, that gets really difficult. And in the episode, you know, Olivia kind of tells her it can be hard when you're too close to the case to make good decisions. And I think that that's something that Kat learns in this episode. So she does go the extra mile to help these people, again, because I think she has a personal connection to them, but also because that's sort of who Kat is. She has a hard time disconnecting her heart from her head.